I am going to narrate some of the finest verses written in Sanskrit relating to honeymoon of Shiva and Uma, a divine couple. Kalidas writes in the 8th canto of Kumar Sambhavam, the marriage ceremony is over. In the mind of Parvati, out of fear, a bit shy and hesitant, love searched for her man. How natural. Looking at her, Shiva too was overpowered by a passionate desire. So shy she was that she didn't reply even when Shiva tried to converse. She tried to run away when he caught hold of her apron. Though sleeping together, she slept, her face turned away from him. Yet, this delighted Shiva all the more. When Shankara, pretending sleep, closed his eyes, Uma turned around and fondly looked at him with a steady gaze. Lo, suddenly he smiled and opened his eyes, mischievous fellow. At once, Uma closed her eyes, as if blinded by a spark of lightning. When Shankara moved his hand towards her navel, tremulously Uma pushed it away. But somehow the knot of her sari loosened and unfastened on its own accord. Parvati's friends instructed her, "Don't be afraid. It happens every day. Learn from us how to cope with Shankara when alone." But no sooner did she face Shiva than she grew so nervous that she forgot all the instructions that had been imparted to her. When they were alone, before her clothes were taken off, Uma with her palms shut both of his eyes so that he could not look at her nakedness. But he, too clever for her, kept his third eye open, rendering futile all her effort. When Mahadev wanted to kiss her, she did not offer her lips. When he wanted to squeeze her in a passionate embrace, she would not raise her arms. In spite of these obstacles and her half-hearted response, when Shiva made love to his bride, it was enjoyable. By and by, writes Kalidas, Parvati overcame her hesitation. She went along with him. If Shiva did not bite her when kissing, if he did not scratch her while caressing, and whenever tenderly he made love to her, but not otherwise. In the morning, when her companions probed as to what had transpired during the night, being shy, she would not utter a word, even though she wanted to bear it all. At times when in a mirror she sat looking at the marks of love left on her body, Shankara arrived stealthily from behind. Parvati felt so awkward that seeing his reflection in the looking glass, she didn't know what to do. Her mother felt gratified that Nilkanth was enjoying her daughter's youth. Assured that her daughter's husband genuinely adored her, a mother no longer has a worry on her mind. For quite some time, Shiva somehow carried on, trying to make Parvati relish the act of love. In course of time, writes Kalidas, having come to know the delights of making love, she gradually overcame her inhibitions. Now when Shankara embraced her tightly, she too responded in equal measure. When he brought her mouth closer to kiss her, avoid him she did not. Half-heartedly she tried to restrain him. Mark the words, half-heartedly. When he fumbled with her waistband, they never tired of praising each other. Mutual admiration, association. They pined for one another even when separated just for a moment. Soon it was apparent, says Kalidas, from their behavior that they were intensely in love. When Ganga comes closer to the ocean, she merges with him, never to return. The ocean too loves to receive water from her repeatedly, and thus he expresses his love for her. Likewise, as Parvati treated her groom as one with herself, he too tried to care for her with equal devotion. In seclusion, Shiva taught Parvati the art of love, so necessary to learn for ladies young. In gratitude, Guru Dakshina she offered him, returning his favor in the same coin, repeatedly making love to him, mind you, a young couple, with all the playfulness of a new bride. Whenever Shiva bit Ambika's lips, she shook her hand in helpless pain. However, immediately she relieved her pain by kissing the cool moon on his forehead. What an image! While she planted kisses thereon, Shankara's third eye hurt from the powder falling from Uma's tresses. In order to smell the fragrance of a lotus in full bloom from her breath, Shiva brought his third eye closer to Parvati's mouth. Under the pretext that she blew the powder away, thus walking the path of sensual pleasure, Shiva obliged Kamdev by availing of his services. Soon it was a month since the new couple had been staying at Himalaya's palace. The self-born asked the Lord of Snows for permission to leave. Himalaya felt a pang of sorrow while bidding farewell to his daughter. Shiva and Uma mounted Nandi, of speed immeasurable, set out on a visit to many a place. Kalidas says, they rode the bull that was faster than the wind. Uma sat in front, Shiva holding in delight her breasts from behind. They arrived at the Meru mountain where they spent the night, making love on a bed made of golden leaves. Every image is perfect, topical, the situation is clear. Mahadev, sipping at Parvati's lotus face, as a bee sucks nectar, moved down to the slopes of Mandarachal mountain, where the rocks carried an imprint of the bracelet of Padmanabha. Here and there, one could see fresh drops of Amrit sprayed at the time of the Samudra Manthan. With Parvati, frightened by a roar from Ravana, holding Shiva in a close embrace with her tender arms, the father of the universe enjoyed the moonlit nights on Mount Kailash. Still further in their wanderings, they arrived at the Malaya Mountains. There the fragrant southern winds, carrying the pollen of the dove club flowers, shaking the tender sandal branches, wiped away like someone making sweet talk Parvati's fatigue caused by love making. In a few images, Kalidas is taking us around the country. At times, Uma played in the waters of the Akash Ganga, waters of Akash Ganga of the galaxy. The fish swimming around her waist made her waistband look superfluous. Classical image, height of imagination. She plucked a golden lotus to playfully hit Shiva. Remember, in Mughal-e-Azam, Dilip Kumar touching Madhubala's face with a feather, and Bade Gulam Ali Khan singing Prem Jogan Banja. Perhaps it was inspired by this image from Kalidas. In turn, Shiva splashed water on her, compelling her to shut her eyes. Reaching Nandanvana, Mahadev adorned Uma with Parijat flowers, blooms that were used in Indrani's hairdo. The Apsaras watched, envious of how skillful Shiva did his job. Enjoying earthly as well as heavenly delights, travelling from place to place, in the company of his beloved, Shankara arrived at Gandhamadan mountain. It was evening and the sun was a ball of red. We propose to take up this narrative where Kalidas describes the passing of the night from the top of the mountain, where Shiva describes the beauty of the Himalayan landscape to Parvati in images which are unforgettable. Till then, I beg leave, I thank you for visiting this site and listening and seeing this video. All the best. Think of Shiva, think of Parvati, enjoy your life. Let your love be pure. Let your honeymoon be as affectionate as that of Shiva and Parvati.